Jet lag is horrible, especially if you've traveled a significant amount of time zones. So how can you beat jet lag fast so you can get on with whatever you need to get on with? Watch on as we discuss. Hey, how's it going? I'm Will. You're watching I & Will, your place to find tips, tricks, and experience in triathlon, multi-sport, and endurance events and training. Jet lag, or as it may also be called, desynchronosis or circadian dysrhythmia, is that awful feeling you get once you've switched a significant amount of time zones, or for instance, when you're doing shift work and you switch from nighttime to daytime. This may cause you to feel extremely tired, nauseous, physically exhausted. I've once fallen asleep in a pizza because of jet lag. And personally, I've experienced jet lag quite a bit. I've done quite a lot of international travel around the world, and most of the time I just kind of deal with it. But recently I think I've found one way that has helped get rid of jet lag much quicker than before. So there are two main tips that I'm gonna get into. The first one is something which is fairly common recommendations and advice online that you can find all over the place, and it has worked okay, but not particularly great. I've always felt pretty crap, especially when going home. But there's a second little tip that I've kind of stumbled upon, and that has helped me pretty much eliminate jet lag so far. So that's what I'm gonna get into today. The first tip, which I said is fairly common knowledge, is to stay awake during the daylight hours and to only sleep during the night hours, once it's properly night hours. Don't sleep during the day and try not to stay awake during the night. One obvious reasoning behind all of this is that if you were to sleep during the day, then you'll feel awake during the night. And if you were to stay awake all night, then you'll feel sleepy during the day. So if you want to adapt to the new time zone that you're in, you need to try and actually stay awake and go to sleep in the proper times of that time zone as soon as you get there. Also, the more that you can stay awake during the day, the more your body will block the production of melatonin, which is the thing that your body produces to make you feel sleepy. So if you are able to stay up as much as possible during the day, every single day, from as soon as you get into whatever country or as soon as you finish whatever shift work, then that sun, that will stop the production of melatonin and it will help you feel more awake during the day and sleepier during the night. Before I go on with the second tip, I just want to let you know that next week on the 15th of August is the world premiere of the Run Nation Film Festival in Sydney, Australia. Of course, I will be attending this. This is an awesome festival full of films about runners. So you find out all about their experiences, their motivation, all that sort of thing throughout different films throughout the night. If you would like to attend this event, I have a discount code that I've been given, so I will leave that in the description box below. It is IronWill2019, I believe. So plug that in once you order your tickets and you can get yourself 15% off an entry. And if you're not in Sydney, then don't worry, this event does travel all across Australia and New Zealand, and it is also doing a world tour, dates and locations to be advised in the future. So keep an eye on the website, which I will leave a link to in the description box below. So the second and probably my main piece of advice to try and overcome jet lag as quickly as possible is to get your heart rate up. And there's a lot of advice out there talking about, you know, going for a walk and that sort of thing, but I'm talking about getting it up, 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 like actually proper, full-on, intensive cardio of some sort to get your heart rate peaking. And this is a great idea for life anyway. Every time when I'm just at regular work and I go for a run or a swim or a bike in the morning, I always feel so much more energized throughout the day. So of course it kind of makes sense that if you were to do this sort of thing as soon as you finish traveling every morning, that you're going to feel a lot more energized throughout the day of wherever you're traveling, and as such, overcome jet lag. It's a great way to say to your body, I'm awake right now, get that blood flowing. And as I mentioned, some great ways to tap into this are the natural triathlon things. So swim, bike, run. You can do those individually or as a sort of your own duathlon or even your own little triathlon. Or You can go into other things like high intensity interval training, HIIT, or martial arts, or whatever gets your blood flowing. And in addition to getting your blood flowing during the day, the exercise also kind of helps wear yourself out during the evening so that you actually stay asleep throughout the whole night without waking up at 2 a.m. with feelings of, I cannot get back to sleep. Now, one argument against the idea of bringing your heart rate up is that you tend to sweat a lot whenever you do high intensity training or bringing your heart rate up. So, of course, one way to counteract this is to make sure that you're properly hydrated. Now, when you're flying, of course, you're doing that recycled air and you tend to get very dehydrated. So make sure that you keep up with the water, keep up with electrolytes, bring those little tabs that you can put in your water. They're great. And you have those when you're exercising, before you're exercising, after you're exercising, and then you'll make sure that you keep yourself nice and hydrated. If you do end up being dehydrated, it could actually make your jet lag a little bit worse. And also, if you have a regular workout back at home, so you work out in the morning, every morning when you're at home, then when you're on holiday, when you've made that jump across multiple time zones, if you were to continue your morning workout in whatever the morning is, wherever you are, then that makes your body clock sort of adjust, or it forces it to adjust. Because when you've got a good rhythm going on in your life, your body knows, I've got exercise, and then I've got work, and then I've got dinner, and then I go to sleep. And if you continue that when you adjust to a new time zone, and you do your exercise in the morning, and then you work, and then you have dinner, and then you go to sleep, or whatever it is, wherever you're going, your body clock will adjust and adapt to the new rhythm, and hopefully eliminate the jet lag. Have you ever used exercise to eliminate jet lag? Let us know in the comments section down below. To check out my previous video about tips for exercising when traveling, I'll leave a link up here. If you want swim, bike, run, and exercise content every week from, well, this week here in Spain and regularly in Australia, then hit that like and subscribe button, and I will see you in the next one. Cheerio.